Welcome to NetVN channel. Someone commented wanting to know how to remotely access files on his computer. And I will do it in this video. The target computer is installed with Windows 11 operating system. First of all, I installed OpenSSH server on Windows 11 operating system. On Windows 10 operating system, you can also install OpenSSH server. OpenSSH server can be installed using the command line, but perhaps using the graphical interface is easier for everyone. By default, the OpenSSH server is off on your computer, so I started it up. I set up the OpenSSH server service to start automatically with the Windows operating system. To remotely access this computer using SSH, you need to set up a password for your computer. If you don't have one on your computer, create one. My target computer doesn't have a password yet, so I create one. This password will be used for remote access using SSH, and you should create a strong password to protect your files. In order to be able to access it remotely via the internet, I forward the port on the router. Before forwarding the port on the router, I need to set up a static IP address for the target computer. Port forwarding on the router requires my computer to have a static IP address set up. In this example, I set the static IP address for the Windows 11 computer to 10.11.3.2.8.4. Next, I set up port forwarding on the router. SSH service uses port 22, so I forward this port to the target computer's static IP address. Port forwarding makes it possible for the remote computer to SSH to the target computer over the internet. Here I forward port 22 to IP address 10.11.3.2.8.4. If your public address is static, then skip the duck DNS configuration step. But my public IP address is dynamic, so I use duck DNS service to update public IP every time it changes. This is the domain name I will use. I use my Google account to log in to duck DNS, then create a new domain name, then map this domain to my public IP address. Next, I install Duck DNS client. This client is responsible for updating the public IP address every time it changes. Duck DNS will then map the changed public IP address to the domain name. Duck DNS application requires the target computer to have Java installed. So if your computer does not have Java installed, please install it. After installing the necessary components, I will set up the Duck DNS client. For this client, you update your domain name. Then you update the token. Each Duck DNS account has a different token. If you update the correct information, it will let you know the setup was successful. Then your public IP address will be updated automatically thanks to Duck DNS client. From the beginning of the video so far, a lot of settings have been created on the target computer, so for those settings to be applied, I restarted the computer. I enter the new password created in the previous step to log into the computer. And that's all the steps to do on the target Windows 11 computer. Now I will access the files of the target computer with another computer through the internet. On the remote computer I install the WinSCP application. Remote desktop you can use different operating system versions like Windows 10, Windows 11 or Windows 7. If you own a static public address you can use it for remote access. But I don't have static public IP address so I use domain name for remote access to files on target computer. Next you enter the username and password that has been set up on the target computer. And here is the result, I can access any file on the target computer. I can access different partitions, even system folders of Windows 11. Therefore, you should set up a strong password to prevent others from accessing your important files. With WinSCP you can upload and download files between two computers. Hope this helps you. Thanks for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe.